Welcome back in the series of lectures on name reaction. Today we are to see an interesting reaction which is called as Reformatsky reaction. Reformatsky reaction is named after the Russian chemist Sergei Nikolaevich Reformatsky, who discovered the reaction in 1887. This is a type of reaction that occurs between an alpha halo ester and a carbonyl compound, which can be a ketone aldehyde or an ester. So this is Sergei Nikolaevich Reformatsky. He was a Russian chemist and he worked and reported the reaction. What is the definition? The reaction of an aldehyde or ketone with an alpha halogen ester in presence of metallic zinc to give alpha beta hydroxy ester is called as Reformatsky reaction. See the definition once again. It is the reaction of an aldehyde or ketone with alpha halo ester, alpha halogen ester, in presence of metallic zinc, and the product is beta hydroxy ester. Of course, it can be beta hydroxy acid ultimately, is called as Reformatsky reaction. Subsequent dehydration of the hydroxy ester leads to the formation of unsaturated ester and internal acid. Okay. See the general reaction. So we start with a ketone, then there is a metallic zinc, then this is alpha bromoethyl ester. In presence of benzene, we get this intermediate adduct. This adduct on hydrolysis gives beta hydroxy ester as the product. Okay. So the reaction hydrolysis is carried out in presence of cold sulfuric acid. In the absence of benzene, that is inert solvent, frequently beta hydroxy ester undergoes dehydration to form alpha beta unsaturated ester, which on hydrolysis gives corresponding alpha beta unsaturated acid. So this was the product in earlier step. This beta hydroxy ester undergoes dehydration and then hydrolysis, giving alpha beta unsaturated acid and ethanol. So let us see the mechanism. In ether medium, the reaction occurs as follows. So inert solvent is preferred. Metallic zinc adds to alpha haloester to form highly polar organo zinc bromide, that is adduct. Organo zinc bromide formation is the first step. The anion of adduct is resonance stabilized. So you have zinc, you have BrCH2COC2H5, you get CH2-, then this is polar adduct with zinc bromide. So the intermediate is further processed. In the second step, nucleophilic addition of enolate anion to the carbonyl carbon of ketone, that is or aldehyde, takes place. So it is nucleophilic addition. This is carbonyl compound. You have this adduct. This adduct undergoes nucleophilic addition. The nucleophilic addition is taking place because the carbon becomes electropositive, oxygen becomes electronegative. So we get ZnBr attached to oxygen, and carbanion CH2- gets attached to the electropositive carbon. So we get an intermediate compound like this, RCr-. So OZnBr is there. So this is intermediate which on hydrolysis gives beta hydroxy ester and ZnBrOH as the byproduct. Okay. So see the reactions once again. See the definition. The reaction of an aldehyde or ketone with an alpha halogen ester in presence of metallic zinc to give alpha beta hydroxy ester is called as Reformatsky reaction. Subsequent dehydration of the hydroxy ester leads to the formation of unsaturated ester and inter acid. The reaction is taking place in this way. General reaction: carbonyl compound, zinc, BrCH2COC2H5, in presence of benzene or ether, the reaction is giving an adduct. Adduct is hydrolyzed by using sulfuric acid to get beta hydroxy ester. So in absence of benzene, the dehydration takes place. So the mechanism is, in the first step we get organo zinc bromide adduct is formed. This organo zinc bromide is a polar component, and this polar molecule undergoes nucleophilic addition, as carbonyl group is polar, carbon becomes electropositive, oxygen becomes electronegative, and we get an intermediate complex like this, and this on hydrolysis gives beta hydroxy ester, okay, which can be subsequently processed as per the requirement. What is the importance of the reaction? The organizing compounds are less reactive than organolithium and organomagnesium compound. Therefore, they are advantageous and they can be handled safely. They do not react with carbonyl group of ester. They can be prepared from alpha haloesters, which generally do not form Grignard reagent. The hydroxyesters and acids obtained are easily dehydrated to form alpha beta unsaturated esters and acids. Other functional groups in carbonyl compound remain unaffected. Besides aldehydes and ketones, nitriles and carboxylic esters can be used. So, these are the various applications. So, you go through these reactions, name reactions carefully prepare accordingly. So, these are the applications. Preparation of beta hydroxy ester, unsaturated ester and alpha beta unsaturated acid. At every stage you get the product can be further processed to get some modified molecule, okay, lengthening of carbon chain. So, same reaction is used for chain extension. Then synthesis of citric acid is carried out by using the same reaction. So, you can remember the titles of these reactions, not necessary to write the reactions. You remember the general reaction, then its application. So, in all these name reactions, what you have to remember is definition of the reaction, general example, a special case and mechanism. That's all. So, with this information, you can prepare for the examination. Thank you.